Welcome friends to the session on communication electronics. In this session, we'll be discussing about the amplitude modulator circuit, and it is being known as AM modulator. In this session, we will understand what we mean by AM modulator, what are the different types of AM modulator, and in detail, we will discuss along with the circuit diagram, the collector modulator, and we will also see the demodulation process. So friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, Learn with Prakash Anare, and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. So let us first of all go for what we mean by the amplitude modulator. You will find that amplitude modulator is an electronic circuit to which we apply the two different types of signal. The first one is the information signal, and this signal is also called as the baseband signal, and this is a low frequency signal. And to this modulator circuit, we will also apply another signal. This is called as the carrier signal, and this is a high frequency signal. And at the output of this modulator circuit, we will get an amplitude modulated voltage. That is, we will get a signal, we will get a carrier signal of which the amplitude is being changed in accordance with this information signal or baseband signal. So AM modulator is an electronic circuit that is being used for superimposing a low frequency signal on the high frequency carrier signal. You will find that the information signal and the carrier signal both are applied to the modulator circuit, and the output will be the modulated signal. Now you will find that depending upon where you are going to apply the modulating signal, there are different types of AM modulator. So in AM modulator, either you can use the vacuum tubes or you can use the transistors as an active device. So depending upon whether you are using vacuum tube or whether you are using the transistor as an active device, you will find that there are different types of modulators. So for example, we have a plate modulator. If you are using a vacuum tube and if you are applying the modulating signal to the plate terminal of the tube, then such modulator is being called as a plate modulator. If you apply your modulating signal to the grid terminal of the vacuum tube, then such modulator is being called as a grid modulator. It is possible that you can apply the modulating signal to the cathode terminal of the vacuum tube, and in such a case, the modulator is being known as cathode modulator. Now, as I told you that instead of vacuum tube, it is possible that you can use a transistor in the modulator circuit. If you use a transistor and if you are applying the modulating signal or the baseband signal to the base of the transistor, then such modulator is being called as a base modulator. Instead, if we apply the input modulating signal to the collector terminal of the transistor, then such modulator is being called as a collector modulator. It is also possible that you can apply the input modulating signal or baseband signal to the emitter terminal of the transistor, and in such a case, the modulator is being known as emitter modulator. So out of these different types, you will find that we'll be discussing in detail the collector modulator, because in our course in detail, we need to discuss about the collector modulator. So let us now go for understanding the circuit diagram of bipolar junction transistor collector modulator or BJT collector modulator. You will find that this circuit consists of a bipolar junction transistor Q1, as shown in the figure, of which the emitter terminal is grounded, and the high frequency carrier signal is applied through some filter circuit to the base of the transistor. You will find that the biasing of this transistor is in such a way that this transistor works as a class C radio frequency power amplifier. Now the collector of the transistor is being coupled to a transformer or to a tuned circuit formed by the inductor and the capacitor. Then you will find that this coil of the tuned circuit is being connected to a transformer T1, the secondary of the transformer T1. This transformer T1 is being known as the modulation transformer. And also you will find that the positive VCC supply, which is required for the biasing of the transistor, is applied through the secondary of the transformer T1 to the collector of the transistor Q1. You will also find that the modulating signal, which is normally coupled through some transducer such as microphone, is being coupled to the high power audio amplifier. And the output of the high power audio amplifier is connected to the primary of the modulation transformer T1. You will find that across the tuned circuit, we will obtain the output of the modulator, and this output of the modulator can be connected to the antenna. So this is a overall circuit for BJT collector modulator. So here you can easily observe that the modulating signal through the transformer T1, we are connecting to the collector of the transistor Q1, and therefore this circuit is being called as a collector modulator. And observe that this transistor Q1, which is used over here, is operated in the class C region. So this is a class C radio frequency power amplifier transistor. Now let us see how this circuit works. Now suppose initially no modulating signal is being applied. When there is no modulating signal or zero input modulating signal, then you will find that there will not be any voltage across the secondary of the transformer T1. That is, there will be zero modulation voltage across the secondary of transistor T1. And therefore the collector supply voltage will be applied directly. So this plus VCC will be directly applied to the collector of the transistor Q1. And this transistor Q1 works as a class C amplifier. And the output will be the carrier, and it will be a steady sine wave. That is, in case of zero modulating signal, you will find that the frequency and the amplitude of the carrier signal will be constant. Now suppose when you apply some modulating signal, then the AC voltage across the secondary of the modulation transformer will be added to the collector supply voltage. So depending upon the cycle, if it has a positive AC cycle, then the more voltage will be applied to the collector of the transistor Q1. If it has a negative cycle, then you will find that the less voltage will be applied to the collector of the transistor Q1. So depending upon the type of the modulating signal, whether it has a positive half cycle or whether it has a negative half cycle, you will find that the voltage at the collector will be slightly higher or lower. So you will find that the varying voltage is being applied to the class C amplifier. And when such varying voltage is applied to the class C amplifier, then you will find that the amplitude of the current pulses through the transistor Q1 will also vary. So the current pulses that are being produced at the output of the transistor Q1 will also vary, because the collector potential of the transistor Q1 is varying. And therefore, you will find that the amplitude of the carrier sine wave will vary, and this variation in the amplitude will be in accordance with the modulating signal. And therefore, at the output here, you will find that across the tuned circuit, we will get a voltage of which the amplitude is continuously varying, and this variation will be in accordance with the modulating signal. Now, let us discuss about the demodulator. You will find that the demodulator is a circuit which is also called as a detector circuit. And this circuit is normally used in receiver. So, modulator circuit is used in transmitter, while the demodulator circuit is used in receiver. So the purpose of the demodulator is to recover the original baseband signal or information signal from the modulated signal. So we can construct a simple amplitude demodulator by using a diode and a filter circuit formed by the capacitor and resistance. Now suppose I have connected a series diode to the input to which I have applied a modulated signal, and the output of the diode is connected to a RC combination where the capacitor and resistance are connected in parallel with each other and they are connected to the output of the diode. So this is a circuit which is a very simple circuit containing only three components, and this circuit can be called as a detector circuit or demodulator circuit, and this circuit will detect or demodulate the input signal. That is, the modulated signal when it is connected to the input of this circuit, then at the output of this circuit you will get your original information signal or baseband signal. Now let us understand the working of this circuit with this diagram. Suppose we have applied a double sideband amplitude modulated signal to the input of the circuit, that is to the diode. Then you will find that this diode works as a halfway rectifier, and therefore at the cathode of the diode terminal you will see that we will get only the positive section of the pulse, that is the section above the axis will be available at the cathode of the diode, while the whole negative portion will be removed at the cathode of the diode. Now this pulse is being applied to the RC combination. Now you will find that the capacitor C will get charged to the positive peak of the each pulse, and after some time interval the next pulse comes in. So again the capacitor C will get charged to the positive peak of the pulse, and this goes on continuously. So whenever there is a gap between the pulses, then you will find that the capacitor C will discharge through the resistance R. But if the value of R is sufficiently large, then the discharge is small. And therefore, whenever you check the voltage across the capacitor, you will find that such type of the zigzag voltage is being obtained across the capacitor. If this voltage is smooth by using some smoothing circuit, then you will find that the shape of this voltage is exactly same to that of the modulating signal. And therefore, we can say that at the output or across the capacitor, what we are getting is the modulating signal or information signal. So in this circuit, at the input we are applying a modulated signal, and at the output we are getting the original baseband signal, and therefore this circuit can be called as a demodulator circuit, or it is also called as the detector circuit. So thank you friends for viewing the sessions. Hopefully you have understood the working of modulator and demodulator in amplitude modulation. And probably in the next session, we'll start with the another topic. Thank you for viewing the session. If you have any queries, then you can write it to me, or you can ask such queries in our oral discussions. Thank you for viewing the session.